everyone. This is Ann from What's Up Homestead, and I thought I would show you how I make salmon patties. It's quick and easy. We used to have it for breakfast. I know that seems kind of weird, but that's the way my grandmother always did. Gave it to us for breakfast with some rice, so that's what I'm making today. So I've got one can of salmon, I've got some crackers, and I've got an egg. That's all that I usually put in mine. You can put salt in there, pepper. I'll probably do that. You can put onion in it. You can do whatever. Some people dredge theirs in breadcrumbs. This is just the easy way that we always do it. So I'll show you what I'm doing. I'm going to drain the salmon. I'm going to leave the salmon in there. I'm just going to drain the juice. And I'm doing it exactly the way my grandmother did it. So that's why I do it that way too. So drain the salmon, and then we're going to put the crackers in there. I really never counted how many I use. I just use enough to soak up the juice in the can. So I'm just going to add some and mix it around. And also with your salmon, it's fully cooked and it has bones in it. Has these round bones, but they're very brittle and you can just squeeze them with your hands. You can just squeeze them and break them up. Some people don't like the skin either, but it doesn't bother me. I just keep everything in there. And you can do it with your hands, you can do it with a fork, but just get your hands in there and just mash everything up and you'll never know that all that is in there. You can always take it out if you're squeamish. But it adds some added protein, so I'm just going to leave it in there. Then I'm going to add one egg. And then I'll stir it together. I'm just going to add a little bit of salt, add some pepper. And sometimes when you spoon them out into your frying pan, you'll kind of find some maybe bones that didn't crush up, and I just mash them up in my hand. Okay, I just take the salmon and I just take a spoon and kind of just use that as a guide. Again, that's the way my grandmother did it. I have also just kind of grabbed them and patted them out. Maybe I'll do it that way. Just patty it out like a hamburger. Then I'm just going to come over here, and I've got just a layer, just to coat the bottom of a cast iron skillet, so I'm going to turn this down a little bit, but I've got avocado oil here, and you can use any kind of oil, vegetable oil, whatever kind you have, and I'm just going to finish these patties and get them fried up and brown them. Okay, they're browning, and if you don't want to fry them in oil, I've also put them on a sheet tray and just greased it or sprayed it with cooking spray and baked them in there, and they're just as good. They might be a little bit drier since you don't fry them, but that's a different way to do it, and it's a little bit healthier. So I will show you what they look like when they're done. Okay, they browned on both sides, and I'm going to get them out of the pan. And I've just got a paper towel on a plate just to drain off the excess. And I hope you enjoyed it. And let me know if you like salmon patties or not and what you put in yours. So I hope this helped.